Kevin Hart may be on the mend after his devastating car wreck, but the conspiracy theories are still swirling. Unfortunately, we'll never know for sure if Kevin was driving that car.
There's absolutely no way Kevin Hart was driving that car.
Okay, that settles that. But wait, how do we know Kevin wasn't driving?
Because Jared Black, his friend, was pinned in the car so badly that the fire department had to cut through the wreckage to actually remove him from the car. So there's no way to swap seats.
Because there was a buzz that the 911 caller said.
The driver is out of the car.
Incorrect. Also,
the injuries that Jared suffered and also the injuries that Kevin suffered are completely consistent with Kevin being in the passenger seat and Jared being in the driver's seat.
Because this
is a 1970s car. There's no harness. It's just lap belts.
That is precisely the way you get the kind of back injuries that both Jared and Kevin suffered because of the lap belt. But Jared also had steering wheel injuries, and Kevin didn't.
Poor Kevin's now got a long recovery ahead of him.
He had three spinal fractures. His rehab is gonna be forever.
But at least the driver mystery is solved.
Everybody was going after him because it looks suspicious, because why did Kevin leave the scene?
Because we've all seen movies where every time a car crashes, it immediately explodes. And you're probably afraid of that.
It's Kevin Hart's own movies that made him think the car was gonna explode.
Oh, he did one too many ride-alongs.
Too many, actually. So, get well soon, Kevin.